Hi everybody, today I'm going to talk about being arrogant or being pathetic. What is better? When I ask this question to most people, they say I would not be both. I don't want to be pathetic, but I also don't want to be arrogant. Let us understand what the word arrogance means. Arrogance here is referring to knowing that you know it. Sometimes we overdo being humble so much that we come to a point that we reach to the level of being pathetic. Let me give you an example. You don't want to go for a function or a social outing, and you instead want to focus that time for yourself. Maybe you want to go for a spa, or maybe you just want to spend some time with your children, or maybe you just want to invest in a good course, or maybe you just want to sit at home, watch TV and do nothing. But just because you don't want to hurt that person, or I would rather say, you don't want to make it look bad. Sometimes you don't even like the person to whose party or whose function you're going. But you can't say a no because you can't say a no. And you feel that, no, I can't. Because if I say a no, this will happen. You know, people in the circle will create a ruckus. Things will go bad. People will think, why is he or she not coming? And so on and on. So if you really look here, you really don't want to go, you really don't connect to the person, you don't want to be a part of that function, but you're just going there to please someone. Maybe to please the person who is inviting you, and even in spite of the fact that you may not like them, you're still doing it. Now this is exactly what I call as being pathetic, which means you know you don't want to do something, but you're not doing it because of XYZ reasons. Which means you're killing that part of you. You're betraying that part of you. This is exactly what I call as self-betrayal. Now, when clients come to me and tell me that, you know, in my life, I have trust issues because people in my life don't stack up to my trust. I trust people blindly, and they, instead of being good to me, they are, in fact, they're betraying me. They're breaking my trust. Now, why is this happening? Because you are betraying yourself. Remember, the world treats you not how you treat them, but the way you treat yourself. For example, if you keep betraying yourself, you're telling the universe that, universe, I don't mind sacrificing myself because sacrificing myself will make me such a good person. You know, that's the biggest lie someone has ever sold to you. And the best way to stop betraying people from coming into your life is by stopping you to betray yourself. So the moment I stopped betraying myself, I started getting people in my life who did not break my trust, as compared to previously where people used to break my trust. Now, this doesn't have to be some big break of trust. It could be even little things like people not standing up to you when you wanting them to stand up to you. This could apply to your close friendships, people at work, anyone and everyone. And remember, relationships is not just about romantic partners, although romantic partners is a part of it. But when we talk about relationships, it's all encompassed. It will include romantic partners as well as all other people. Now, when you are being pathetic to yourself, which means you're not acknowledging what you truly are. You are, in fact, giving power to others. You are letting others' judgment define you. Imagine someone telling you that you're like this. You know, many people say that, to know how you are, ask your best friend. No, why you want to ask your best friend? Your best friend really might not know what you are, but you know them better than that. And to know yourself better, that's the reason I talk about doing self-work. So yes, of course, it's good to ask your best friend, but if you're going to let your best friend's opinion determine what you are, it's not going to work. Also, many times it happens that we cling on to what we were previously. Okay. For example, in school days, in college days, you were a particular person. But now over a period of time, we all evolve. And you better evolve, because if you don't evolve, you are just there. You are stagnating in life. So the image of what you were as someone in school or someone way back in college and the person you are now has totally changed. And that's the reason, if you keep evolving, you keep changing. So I'm not saying become someone else. Become the best version of yourself. Evolution is you becoming the best version of yourself and not you becoming someone else. For example, when Ashwini evolves, she becomes the best version of herself. She doesn't become, say, Anna, or she doesn't become, say, someone else, but she becomes the best version of yourself. So when we say evolve or change, it means you become the best version of ourselves. We all go from a stage of metamorphosis when we evolve. So evolution happens not just at physical level, but also at emotional, mental, spiritual level. At all these levels, when you evolve, you become a different person than what you were maybe 10 years ago, maybe 15 years ago, maybe even 2 years ago. Like, I see myself evolving. I'm a totally different person from who I was 2 years ago. And that is the beauty of evolution. You evolve. You keep evolving all throughout your life. The evolution doesn't end. So when you evolve and when you become a better person, or when you become the best version of yourself, you start connecting to what you call as your highest energy. You start understanding what are those things within you which are important for your growth. You connect to your own growth, and that makes you great. Now, look at it. This is very important, and many times people don't understand this. When you are evolving, okay, you start knowing what you truly are. Just as I said, your best friend will not know what you are, because your best friend might cling on to a version of you were when they and you were together all the time. Like, for example, your best friend from college will say, okay, Ashwini is this kind of a person. My best friend from school will say, okay, Ashwini is this kind of a person. Maybe my best friend from my workplace will say, okay, Ashwini is this kind of a person. But the beauty of evolution is you will not be that person anymore. And that might even shock and surprise your best friends. And I always feel if they're your true best friends, they will love, accept, approve. You don't need anyone's approval or acceptance, but they will stay in your life because they love to see you evolving, and they will evolve with you. And the people who don't like to see you growing, the people who don't like to see you evolving, will actually be, they will move away from your life. And coming back now to being arrogant versus being pathetic, what would you rather be? And most people will say, I don't want to be labeled as arrogant because it's supposed to be a bad thing. I would rather be pathetic. People so want to be humble and so want to be good, nice, that they really do not use their awareness to see what is truly about living life in joy. So people will love to sacrifice themselves, will love to self-sabotage, self-harm, self-betray, but not believe in knowing what they truly are. I know a lot of people who overdo being humble. Trust me, it's very important to be humble. It's very important to be kind, but not at the cost of self-sabotaging. You can be totally, be a kind person at the same time, not self-sabotage. So in Access Consciousness, that was the first time I understood what does it mean to be arrogant versus being pathetic. Because all my life, I so wanted to be pathetic that I was never arrogant. Even when people at work used to, you know, what I call as make me do extra work, or I used to be taken for granted, used to take my credit. I never stood up for myself and said that, oh, no, this is not fair. And because I didn't want to be arrogant, and I rather chose to be pathetic. But when I understood the difference between arrogance and being pathetic, was I realized that arrogance actually means that you know what you're truly capable of, and you're not going to take anything less than that. Knowing what you deserve and not settling for anything less than that is the true definition of the word arrogance. Forget about the dictionary meaning of the word arrogance, what is written in dictionary, because many times we like to put people in boxes. But what if you can be arrogant and kind at the same time? What if you know your worth and stop settling for anything below that? How does it get even better than this? When we talk about all of this, this is a very empowering thing for people, because I see most people suffer because they overdo trying to be good. And there is so much judgment about what is good and what is bad. And very quickly, we want to put people in boxes. Very quickly, we want to say, oh, this person is career oriented, she must be arrogant. Oh, this person is a good cook, I'm sure she is, she's not good at doing office work. Oh, this person, and I see a lot of women especially doing that. We like to put people in boxes. So how about someone who can be a good cook and yet can be someone who is career oriented person? And how about someone who can be a career oriented person yet be a good mother? And how about someone who is very kind person, but yet she knows her worth and she stands up for herself? So would you be arrogant or would you be pathetic? What do you choose? If this video makes sense, please drop comments below. And today, right below this video, click the subscribe button in order to subscribe to our channel on YouTube. If you're watching us on social media, which is on Facebook or Instagram, do not forget to follow us and like us. Share this video with as many people as you can. This is Ashwini Chubey. I am a motivational speaker, I'm a personal growth coach, access consciousness facilitator. I'm also a tarot reader and an angel card reader. And if you like my work, you can log on to www.unicorninsight.com. And yes, to book a personalized coaching or a tarot card reading with me, you can drop an email on ashwini.chubey@unicorninsight.com. We only do readings, coaching, and sessions on prior appointments. So please connect if you wish to have a session with us. Thank you for watching, and I'm sending you lots of peace, joy, and glory to wherever you are in this world. Thank you.